Hello and welcome back to this European Schoolnet Academy Games in Schools course. This is module 4 where we're talking about what can we learn from games. In this short video, we're going to be talking about augmented reality. Augmented reality has been around for a little while now, and the basic premise of it is that you can take a digital device, such as a tablet or a smartphone, and when you hold this device up to the real world, you're able to augment digital data and digital information over the real world. This has become increasingly sophisticated because a lot of modern augmented reality applications also use the internet through 4 and 5G and the devices compass and smartphone so that you can get real-time updates. To give you an example of augmented reality in practice, you might want to have a quick look at what's happening here with this IKEA app. Again, a very, very simple idea. You take virtual furniture from the catalogue, you go to a place in your home where you might like to have that piece of virtual furniture, and then you can view to see what that piece of furniture might look like actually in your home yourself. Pretty clever, isn't it? Augmented reality has become popular in recent years due to the rise in different augmented reality games. There are a number of very popular games out there on the market at the moment. The most popular is, of course, Pokemon Go, but it's also being rivaled by Harry Potter Wizards Unite. Augmented reality games aren't a particularly new thing, though. Spectrek, where you chase virtual ghosts around your local neighbourhood, has actually been around for a long time. You might remember that in the last module, where we were looking at movement games, we mentioned that games like Pokemon Go have been found to improve people's exercise rates for a short period of time. Of course, it's not just modern games that have come under the new domain of augmented reality. One of my favourite educational games of all time is Scrabble. Of course, Scrabble has been translated into many different languages all around the world. The interesting thing about Scrabble is over time it's been digitised. This includes, for example, a game for handheld devices, and also, more recently, games for social networking sites such as Facebook. There's also an augmented reality version of Scrabble. It's not an official Scrabble app, but it works in exactly the same way. It's called Seek and Spell. How this works is that you download the app and then you go and find a space where you're going to play the game. Normally, this would be a large open area, and most importantly, it would be a really safe area. Then, in the place, you press start, and what happens is that augmented letters appear in the area where you're going to play the game. And then, over a period of time, it's up to you and your components to run around the space in order to collect the different letters to be able to spell different words. So a very simple version of Scrabble, which has been updated for an augmented reality era. Augmented reality in the past has also been popular on games consoles. The reason that I mention it here is because even though it's not so much popular on the modern games consoles, there are still a lot of Xboxes and PlayStation 3s in schools. My two favourite augmented reality apps and games for these consoles were Sesame Street TV, based on the popular TV series Sesame Street, where you could actually interact with the characters using the Xbox Kinect, and also the Sony iPet, where you could look after a virtual pet. Again, the reason that I mention it here is that there are still a lot of these consoles in schools, or there's an opportunity for teachers that have got these consoles at home to take them into their classroom and still use the games, which are now increasingly available and also very, very cheap. Let's now have a different look at some different types of augmented reality app to give you an idea of the sorts of things that are possible. The first app that we're going to look at is just the simple measure app, which normally comes in your iPhone or on your iPad. As you can see from looking at the video, it allows you to take fairly accurate measurements just by using the camera and augmented reality on your screen. Of course, it's not 100% accurate, but it gives you an idea of the sorts of things that you might be able to do. Another of my favourite augmented reality apps, although people don't always think it as an augmented reality app, is actually Google Translate. And as you can see in this video here, what happens is you use the camera function of Google Translate, and when you put it over typed words, it's able to translate it into a different language. This is another great example of augmented reality. Moving on to something a little bit more sophisticated, this is an app which is called Quiver. The reason that I like it is because it combines pictures that you colour in, and then when you view the pictures via the augmented reality app, it brings these pictures to life and they just jump out of the screen. What's nice about it though is because you've coloured it in, or because the children have coloured it in, there's a certain degree of ownership in the work. The next augmented reality app we're going to look at is something which is called AR Dino Park. It's a pretty simple idea really. You walk around a local public place, and when you use the app, you're able to superimpose dinosaurs into the real world. It's great for exploring what prehistoric life might have been like, and it's also a great context for things like creative writing. The last one I want to talk about is something which is called Starwalk. When Starwalk was first introduced for the iPad a number of years ago, people thought it was a big joke, but of course, it was one of the first augmented reality apps on the market. What you do with it is you hold the app up to the sky and it superimposes what the stars look like and also labels them. This can be really handy at night time because it can show you where the stars are and see them, but of course you can also use it in the daytime as well to study things like astronomy. Don't forget that things like Starwalk are not only used to study things like astronomy, they can also again be used as a great stimulus for literacy and creative writing skills. I couldn't really finish this video without mentioning HoloLens. HoloLens is a Microsoft product which actually was released around the same time as we did the last games course. One of the challenges of HoloLens is it's incredibly expensive, although it is also incredibly powerful. What I wanted to mention about HoloLens is there's lots of talk about how you might be able to use it to do things that you've not done before. Although I see the point of this, for example, looking at this giant heart and dissecting it, where I really see the power of HoloLens is being able to superimpose virtual data into a real place. I think it's got a massive amount of potential in things like the construction industry, where you're actually able to walk into a real life giant area and see what's happening underneath the ground. Or, for example, if you were going to work into a shop where cars and lorries were being serviced, being able to look inside these cars and lorries to see what you might have to do. We're yet to see the real benefit of HoloLens in education, partly because of the lack of educational apps, but also partly because of the expense. So that's our brief introduction to augmented reality. And during the introduction, I introduced you to a number of different augmented reality apps. What I'd like you to do is go away and just experiment with a few. It might be a simple Google Translate app. You might want to have a go at Virtual Scrabble. Maybe you want to take a picture of a dinosaur in your garden or in your school grounds. Or perhaps you want to explore the night sky using Starwalk. Whatever you choose, see if you can come to grips with augmented reality and have a think about how you might be able to use it in the classroom. Don't forget, we're going to be discussing augmented reality and swapping some of your favourite apps online. Use the hashtag GamesCourse to get you started doing this.